Okay guys, so today's my birthday and that means I'm turning
30.
Just kidding.
I don't put a lot of emphasis on like age and everything. It's literally just a number. So actually for my 30th birthday, because obviously I'm filming this before my 30th birthday so that it can be up on my 30th birthday. But for my 30th birthday, I don't know how many times I'm going to say 30th, I am actually getting vaccinated because Idaho is finally allowing regular people to be vaccinated. So I will be doing that. I just wanted to show off some of the stuff I did get for my birthday, which I didn't get for my birthday. It was just stuff people sent me around my birthday. And one of them is my Holy Grail Golden Glitter Ariel doll from Simba Toys. And if you guys don't know, Simba Toys is like a UK exclusive kind of doll line. And they look a lot kind of like those Steffi dolls. Do they make Steffi? They might make Steffi.
Yes.
And we get a lot of those in the States, but we don't really get like these Disney princesses. And her hair's a little messed up, so we're gonna have to clean that and everything, but I love her. She's a little worse for wear, but she's still so pretty, and she's one of my grail dolls, and I got her, and this is just exciting. This was sent to me from Barbination because he does live in Holland, which, you know, is in Europe, where you can get these dolls, and I just really, really appreciate that. So definitely go check out his Instagram and his channel down below. And then one of my lovely subscribers sent me this, and once again, thank you so much. I won't say their name just in case they don't want me to, but they know who they are, they watch my videos, and I super duper appreciate them. And it is the New England Escape accessory, like, fashion pack kit from the Barbie Fashion Model Collection from 2003. So I'm just gonna show this off in this video, and we'll probably do like a whole unboxing and try on video. But yeah, I just, thank you so much. Like, I don't really have subscribers send me stuff because I don't have a PO box and I'm not giving out my like address to just anybody, but this is super beautiful and I really appreciate it. They were like, yeah, I just have one in my garage if you want it. Like, they just have like Barbie Fashion Model Collection stuff lying around. I love that. So yeah, if you're just so sick of your Barbie Fashion Model Collection stuff, you know, I'll probably take it. Anyway, that's just some stuff I got for my 30th birthday. We are actually doing the fourth anti-doll, anti-haul. Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today is my 30th birthday.
Happy birthday, bitch!
But it's also the fourth anti-doll, anti-haul that I'm doing. I try to do these like once a month, but there's not enough products coming out, first of all, that we're aware of. And it was hard for me to come up with things that I didn't like because most of the stuff I do like. So maybe I could do like a smoky glow kind of video where she does like yes or pass, where she talks about stuff she wants to buy and talks about stuff she doesn't want to buy. Like, and maybe I could do that once a month instead of just doing an anti-doll, anti-haul, because I can't just do anti-hauls for dolls. We just don't have enough coming out. And for those of you that don't know what an anti-haul is, that is a way to counteract the kind of over-consumerism that's just being thrown at us, where they're like, you need to buy this, and this, and this, and this, and this, and blah, blah, blah. Oh, your stimulus just came in? Well, spend it all on some shitty Fashion Nova clothing. Like, it's just stuff like that, where we don't need to spend money. I don't need to spend money. I'm in college. Like, I'm barely scraping by up here. Like, this is rough. And I need to tell myself not to buy stuff all the time, and I'll still buy it. Like, it's really hard. So videos like these kind of help me curb my spending habits, make me be like anti-capitalism, like rah rah, you know, down with the establishment.
Remember to rebel against authority, kids!
And these kind of videos were popularized by a drag queen, activist, YouTuber extraordinaire, Kimberly Clark. And I actually learned about anti-hauls from watching Abby Williamson here on YouTube. So yeah, that's just what this is all about. I just want you guys to know that if you love any of the stuff I'm talking about in this video, it's not a personal attack on you. You spend your money however you want. I'm gonna spend my money however I want, and hopefully this video will help other people not spend as much money.
Okay, so also I forgot to say that I have like a bunch of different Instagrams and other sources from where I got all these doll images. Everything will be linked below, and channels, Instagrams, websites, stuff like that, like everything, to give credit where credit's due. I always do that stuff, but sometimes I forget to mention it in my videos.
Do you guys like my birthday outfit and my Chubbies brand? All right, let's get into the anti-haul. Got my trusty, dusty, loud-ass table that's really flimsy. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna anti-haul is this ColourPop X Disney Lizzie McGuire collaboration, whatever it is. The 90s kid that grew up watching Disney Channel, Nickelodeon, and Cartoon Network in me, like, loved this early 2000s aesthetic and everything, but I just need to talk myself out of buying it because no way would I wear these colors. ColourPop is very inexpensive, but I barely use the makeup I have, and I have that stupid dumbass Pat McGrath palette that's beautiful, but I've only worn it like twice. This stuff is gorgeous, but I don't need any of it. It's all cute, very early 2000s, very nostalgic, love everything about that, but I don't need this. One thing I am interested in, though, is this Elf x Chipotle collab. Elf is even more inexpensive than ColourPop, and I just love the color story. They really stuck to the theme here. Like, the greens, the golds, and the tans, like, it's very pretty. The avocado sponge is so adorable. Like, everything about this I love. So, this I would consider buying if it showed up at, like, Walmart one day, or Ulta. But I'm not going to go like out of my way to buy it online or anything. But God, that avocado sponge is so cute. So obviously these were going to be on the anti-haul. And that is these swimming color reveal Barbies. Like, what the f***? Like, no. Girl, okay. So I talked about this when they were first released. And I can't remember who told me in my DMs, but they're like, well, they have plastic hair because they're, like, swimming Barbies. And I'm like, okay, but Barbie's been able to swim with rooted hair forever. And the idea of these girls having, like, molded-on plastic hair, it just makes them feel like they're one of those cheap knockoff Barbies you would see at, like, some weird discount store. Barbie's starting to become, like, the knockoff version of herself. And everything, and this plastic hair, like, plastic hair on Kens makes sense because it's short hair that's sculpted, and we know if you root Ken hair, while yes, rooted Ken hair is awesome, it goes everywhere and it has to be, like, massively gelled down just to stay in place, and if you try to do anything with it, it will get ruined. But on a Barbie, I just, plastic molded on hair, like, no.
No.
Like, even for color reveal, this is bad. Like, even on the little girls, they don't look like them. This doesn't look like a Barbie to me. This looks like a Polly Pocket or something. Like, there's just no way. Like, everything about this I hate. We all know color reveal is trash, but this is like color reveal trash level right here. And this is like color reveal molded on plastic hair. Like, I didn't think they could go lower, and they did.
Still a piece of garbage.
And I guarantee you, these are probably still around like the $15 price point, which is just absurd. Because for $8, we can get a fashionista with clothing that is removable and non-plastic hair. Like, this just bugs the shit out of me. But surprise, it's color reveal, right? So next up, I'm anti-hauling this because while I think this is cool, and he was definitely one of my first crushes growing up, I just don't think I'll need it, but it looks really cool and it's fully posable and it comes with all these accessories, so I'm like jumping back and forth. But it is this Where's Waldo figurine from Blitzway. I was reading about it on Instagram, and apparently Blitzway is like a really not the most ethically business practice kind of business, and they said, like, what we're seeing in the pictures we would never get in real life. I don't know anything about Blitzway, but if anybody else has dealt with them, let me know if they're really good at, like, that false advertising and everything. But I think this is adorable. And obviously, like, the stand it comes with, the articulation, the accessories, like, it's super cute. Like I said, he was one of my first nerd crushes growing up. Like, I loved Finding Waldo. It just is what it is. And in every picture, he's, like, different. Because in this picture, he has, like, a fabric shirt and fabric pants. But then in the next picture, it's plastic pants and a plastic shirt with, like, what? That, those are clearly two different things. Like, wait, what the hell? Why is it doing that? Are there, like, two different ones? No, that's so misleading. Wait, what? That makes no sense. And they both have different stands. Okay. So maybe if the cloth one is the one you can get, and if he was at a 6th scale, because the plastic one is at a 1/12th scale.
I am confusion.
No, I'm jumping back and forth on this. I don't need this. It's cute. And even if I did get him, it would mostly be for the accessories. The next thing I want to anti-haul are these glow up girls. They are adorable. Like, I will give them that. But they have that, like, kiddish, immature look to them. But I think they're supposed to be, like, teenagers, but they look like children. I really only like the redhead, the deeper girl, and then the kind of purple-haired mermaid-themed girl. Like, those are the only ones I really like. So I might pick up one of those just to see what the dolls are about. But this looks like something like Mormons would create to make a trendy fashion doll, but then like super conservative, like sleeves and everything, which I know sounds weird because the deeper girl is wearing like that fur, like hooker coat, and she has like the giant thigh high boots and everything and the little like peekaboo cleavage. But like even that, these still feel like ultra like conservative Mormony fashions to me. I can't explain it. It's just, these are not for me. But I'll probably pick at least one of them up. It may be the purple-haired mermaid girl, maybe the redhead, or it may be the deeper girl. Next up, I'm anti-hauling the dream house. These dream houses are getting more and more expensive, but less and less quality. Barbie dream houses have always been that kind of like hollowed out walls, columns, sticker on furniture background kind of bullshit. But this is like, I don't know why this one bothers me so much. It's not that different from like the other ones. Maybe it's because the roof line's really lazy or something. I do like that the elevator now can fit like a wheelchair. I think that's awesome. That's a step in the right direction. But like two or three dream houses ago, it had like a garage and a pool, and this doesn't even have that. Like, this is just, I don't know. This is bugging me. The way the furniture's set up, the patio, all that stuff, like, I feel like there's just like a lot of empty, useless space. So maybe this would be like a fun shell in a couple of years to like recreate your own after people get sick of it and start selling it on Facebook Marketplace for like $50. But like for right now at full price, because I'm sure it's like $160 or $180. That's what the Barbie houses have been getting up to lately. I'm not a big fan of it. Yeah, I don't know. It's just not hitting me. It's not like any different from any other Barbie house recently. It's just this one's more offensive to my eye. I don't know why. So, first of all, I absolutely loved this show. I thought it was super fun. I'm glad I started watching it when we were like 4 episodes in, because I probably would have abandoned it. But it got really, really good. The ending couldn't, I don't know. I feel like the ending couldn't live up to the hype that people were expecting the ending to live up to. So I'm not like upset about how the series ended. I liked it ultimately. But this Scarlet Witch doll from the Disney store, I just don't like the way it came out. Like, I feel like it could have been done so much better. The face kind of looks like the actress. It's super bulky. It just looks really awkward. Her hair, I can tell, has a shit ton of product in it. While I think this is great for like fans that do like the show, because I like the show, and for people who were like really into this, like kudos, like go get your doll, girl. But for me, I don't think this is like the best they could have done for a doll for the Scarlet Witch. But yeah, that's just me. I don't know. You guys let me know if this is like the best way they could have done this, if this just absolutely looks like her. Ugh. Okay, so here's some more Disney shit. The Raya Hasbro dolls are just Hasbro girl, what are you doing? She has a plastic molded on top. Like, and no articulation. She is in the movie kicking ass the whole time, and you couldn't give her at least like a fist and a sword to hold it. Like, this is just a hair play accessory kit, and then it comes with the weird monkeys from the movie, and you could have taken all those accessories away and given her some articulation. Like, this is bullshit to me. Like, it wasn't even that long ago that they had the license for Captain Marvel, and I know those dolls didn't do that well, but they were at least articulated and could punch and fight, and Raya's supposed to be able to do that, and she's not doing that here. And Hasbro, I don't know what you're doing. Honestly, like, if you want a Disney princess doll, go to the Disney store and get one, or buy it from the Disney store online, because this is bullshit. Like, the fact that she can't even bend her arm, like, what the f***? Hasbro, what are you doing, girl? Mm-mm. Okay, y'all, did you forget about this? Because I did for a second. It is the Cardi B doll. I'm anti-hauling it. One, because it's, like, it's in the weird MGA proportions and everything, and I'm not, like, the biggest fan of Cardi B. I don't have a problem with her, and I don't have a problem with that WAP song. Like, you do you, girl. I'm all about, like, sex positivity. But the doll itself, I'm just not feeling it. Obviously, this is, like, a CGI rendering of the doll, but I don't know. She said something in the interview about it where she's like, well, everybody else is getting into the doll business and making money, so why don't I? And I don't know. I just feel like it's kind of weird to just like jump right in and just expect to make money out of it. Obviously, dolls cost a lot of money to make because Barbie's shitty quality keeps going down. And there's something about like dolls where it's like, yeah, no, it's not that easy to make a doll. I think they said at the very minimum, like a mold for a doll's body costs like $50,000 to make the mold or something like that. So that alone is like setting you back. Jumping into the doll community and being like, oh yeah, I just want to do it just, you know, because like, whatever, like if it's something you're passionate about, like you can have another doll line. But if you're just like doing it for a quick cash grab, that's just not my thing. Ugh. God, there's just more Hasbro Disney on here. And it's just all of the new Disney princess dolls. Not a lot to say here. Shitty plastic molded on tops. The faces look better. They stopped whitewashing Jasmine. Tiana even looks better. Pocahontas, her skin tone looks a lot better. Like, the faces look better in the Hasbro dolls now, but I wish what they would do are the face molds now, but the old just cloth dresses. They weren't anything super special, but they were pretty, they were printed beautiful, and they were like $8 to $10. And these dolls, it just bothers me because like I said earlier, it costs about like $50,000 to make a doll mold, and there are 12 princesses here in this picture. So you had to go create like a new body mold for all these shitty molded on plastic top dolls. So what is that? 50,000 times 12 equals 600,000. Why did I have to calculate that? So $600,000, in theory, just based off what I'm told, I could be totally wrong, but $600,000 to create new molds for these Disney princesses to give them shitty molded on tops. How is that cheaper than just giving them cloth dresses and a similar body mold style? Like, that's so stupid to me. Like, if that is the case, that is, like, to me, an egregious waste of money because it looks shitty. I don't know how it's cheaper. God, I wish I could just talk to, like, the CEO of, like, some doll company and ask them, how is it cheaper to make molded-on plastic tops instead of that weird, shitty... Because that's the thing. They're not using premium, like, fabrics on these dolls. It's that weird, shitty paper fabric that you guys can, like, print shit on. Like, I don't understand. It's so stupid to me. Oh my god. I'm getting upset about dolls I'm not fucking buy. Like, that's so dumb. Happy 30th birthday. Okay, once again, more Hasbro. And this, I love the idea of. I think the execution is complete dog shit. And that is the spin and switch bell where she's supposed to go from her blue dress to her yellow dress, and then the body, like, flips around and everything. So the major problem with this is because it's that shitty molded on plastic top, it's blue. So it'll only match if she is in her blue peasant dress when she's walking through the village, not her yellow gown that's iconic. because you can't switch the shitty molded on plastic top, at least from what I'm seeing here in the pictures. I could be totally wrong. Even her shoes are molded on. This, that...
Why?
Next. Okay, so the final thing we are anti-hauling is integrity toys, like, in general. Like, I don't buy a shit ton of integrity toys, but I'm getting more and more turned off from the brand. And let me explain in, like, better detail. The pricing for the quality, the fabrics, the doll face molds, everything, I always thought was a really, really good deal. I do think it's weird that their bodies feel kind of cheapy, hollowed out plastic. Like, I would like if integrity dolls for the price had a little more heft to them or weight. They've never, like, when you're holding the doll, it doesn't have that heavy luxury doll feel, but it has that luxury doll look. The thing that bothers me the most with Integrity Toys is their antiquated business model. They're getting better about it now, where they actually do direct sales from their website. I do like that and appreciate that. But they have this antiquated way of, like, doing the doll dealers. And I think that was fine in, like, 2002, but it's 2021. I just really feel like Integrity should just sell their shit online, limit the quantities you're allowed to buy, because I'm so sick of scalpers buying this $150 and then turning around and trying to sell it for like $700-$800. I don't necessarily have a problem with like resale and making like a small profit off of dolls and stuff, but just gross stuff like that, or people who buy like six of the damn dolls and then start selling them like piece by piece. They'll be like, here's their bracelet, here's their head for like $150, which is the price you bought the doll for. Like, it's just bullshit to me. And like, Integrity, I don't feel like they do anything to like prevent scalpers from just scooping up all their shit. It just bothers me. I don't know, it feels antiquated, because even like Barbie on her own website is like, nah, you can only do like two of these per household, you know, to help prevent scalping. And people still scalp stuff because Barbie's distribution system is weird. There's way too many channels. It can just show up anywhere, like Target, her own website, Amazon. Barbie's too dispersed. Integrity is too limited. I don't know. So Integrity bothers the shit out of me just because of how old and antiquated their system is. And they're like, objectively, they're the most stunning doll line that we have access to for the most part. Like, Barbie can't even get close to this anymore. And so it just bothers me that they do this incredibly old style of business. I don't know. Let me know what you think about Integrity down below. I think it's old. I don't know how it benefits the dealers to only be able to sell like two or three dolls at a time. I don't know. Let me know. Okay, guys, so that was my fourth anti-doll anti-haul on my 30th birthday. Let me know down below things that you don't want to buy or that you're not sure if you want to buy or not. Maybe you want to save some money somewhere. Just let me know. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. God, I was getting so angry there for a second. Like, Hasbro, girl, what are you doing? You have the Disney Princess license and you're gonna shit on it. You're gonna lose it like Mattel did, and then it's gonna have to go to like fucking MGA, and they're gonna make all the Disney princesses look like fucking aliens. Okay, but like, I love these chubbies. Like, girl, who is she?